I feel weird.
The pad, bro, the pad.
Yeah, the pad.
Everybody talks, everybody talks, everybody talks. It started with a whisper.
First Blair crush.
Ty Whittemore.
Jay Bocci.
Kevin Dittman.
Tim Launders reaches a day.
John Haddon.
Sorry, Jules.
Probably John Wall.
I asked someone to gorm, and they said no, and then everyone knew about it.
He asked me to gorm my freshman year, and I said I didn't like gorm and proceeded to go to gorm with my friends the next day.
Thomas Robinson.
Valid.
Peter Lau.
Sophia Kaspark. I think the first week of school, I already thought that she was really cute.
I had a huge crush on Khaki. On my freshman letter to my senior self, I wrote, "You like pants to remind me," as a PS. And yeah, that never worked out.
Jack Blanco? I think Jack Blanco, or it could have been Jack Weber.
Katie Miller.
Grace Rayer.
Even Offman.
Or Angel.
Either Owen or Kevin. One or the other.
Jalen Blakes.
Thomas Walker.
Sophia Kasparik.
I think my freshman year crush is probably Molly Sisler.
I was having a crush on Tess at Sadie.
What is your favorite Blair memory?
One time I twisted my ankle in this room with Grace. This is Grace. And I made Grace carry me to the health center. And then on the walk back, I heard a noise and got scared, so I bit her in the shoulder.
My favorite Blair memory was the senior pool party. Senior girl pool party.
We found out that there was a headmaster's holiday in the dining hall. And I don't remember who jumped up and yelled it first, but everyone went absolutely insane in the dining hall. People were like throwing things and jumping on the tables and dancing. And later that night, because, you know, we didn't have school the next day, basically, long story short, we moved every piece of furniture in front of Lucas and Patrick's room.
All the bus rides to lacrosse games.
All of Petty Week this year. Like, the hockey goal in the Andy Common room. And
when Lindsay J wore this exact outfit to the day of our filming. Pant to the outfit.
One year, D-Squad, when we all got stormed in. And we all were stuck in Hardwick, and we played hide-and-go-seek.
In sophomore year, we went to Lawrenceville, the field hockey team, and we, like, notoriously have lost. Like, that was just, like, we had a huge pep talk before the game, like, don't, like just keep your spirits up, like, basically, like, preparing us for the loss. It was the first time the Blair field hockey team, varsity team, has beat Lawrenceville in 50 years.
First soccer fest.
Nate learning to rhyme. He didn't know how to rhyme, so we were sitting there trying to give him words, and I was like, okay, Nate, like, what rhymes with fate? And he just, like, sat there for a minute, and he didn't know what to say, and he's, like, thinking, and Carson's there like this, like, Nate! And he just couldn't figure it out for, like, 2 minutes, and then he was like, oh.
Wait, what rhymes with fate?
His name.
Oh, yo! Okay.
most embarrassing moment?
Making a school meeting announcement with Zora wearing the same exact thing.
Went up on stage wearing the same exact outfit. That was pretty bad.
Freshman year, I had a stomach bug, and I, like, Sid Mehta said, let's go to dinner. And when I got down there, like, all the food made me feel really nauseous. So I walked down the admissions hallway and I threw up in front of Mr. Curran's office. And then I was like, oh God, I need to tell a teacher about this. So I walked to Ms. Conforti's office and then I threw up in her office.
So freshman year, so everyone's basically playing JV soccer. And I never played soccer before. And I thought it was okay to kick the ball out of the goalie's hands, and I ended up kicking her in the face, and I got a yellow card.
I made an announcement at Friday school meeting, and Hoffman followed me and told the entire school that I mocked.
Oh, I didn't know who Mr. Fortunato was. I looked to my right, and I didn't know who he was or the headmaster, so I was like, oh, who are you? And then he said, Mr. Fortunato. And I looked dumb. Everybody looked at me crazy, but I was like, oh. Nice to meet you.
To throw an egg at like a sheet in Mr. Thatcher's class. And first he asked for volunteers. And so Belle was like, all right, I'll go. And Belle was like so ready and she threw it and she missed the tarp and like smashed against the whiteboard. And everyone went crazy. And Mr. Thatcher was like, oh, Jenna, like JVB, you play softball, you got this. I got up and I missed it even more than Belle did. Like it smashed across the top of the wall.
I hate to admit it, but the Dior 2001 performance was slightly embarrassing.
First game at Phelps, I shot the ball off the side of the backboard in the corner. Remember that?
Yes, I do.
And everybody was like, three! Oh!
This is so bad. So it was last junior year, at the beginning of the year, and it was like one of the school meetings where like trustees were there, like visiting. Walk out of Armstrong and all the trustees are like waiting in the rotunda. And I like walk out, I'm walking to lunch, I'm like, okay, like whatever, good day. Finally, like Jules comes sprinting up to me because my skirt was like completely caught up my backpack the entire time.
She walked like
I walked right
50
past,
feet with
right
her butt
past
out.
All the trustees with my complete butt out.
One time I peed my pants in the dining hall.
This was in the Annie Common room, and I remember I was walking back, trying to find my way back to Catherine, and I ended up walking past Armstrong, and there's a security truck, and I asked the security truck, I'm like, how do I get back to Catherine? And he starts laughing at me.
It was pretty late. We had these little like twinkly lights surrounding our bed because our beds were bumped. Grace was just like playing with the lights, and you somehow got the end of the twinkly lights caught in a strip. All of a sudden I see this huge flash and this loud bang, and I was like, she's dead. Next morning, Miss Lang comes out to talk to us. I was like, some of the girls are complaining that like there was a power outage like in South, and like that their outlets weren't working. Like, do you know anything about it? Nope.
We just didn't know.
The flight deck prefects blindfolded us and took us to the graveyard, and then Mr. Compton read us like weird Celtic poetry, and I was so confused. I was just like, damn, okay, I'm just joining a cult right now.
Thinking about you as I'm lying next to someone else. Drinking without you doesn't fix me, but it kinda helps. Oh, I still wish we could go back to where we started. T-shirt at my old apartment. Have you ever wondered if you love me harder? Where we be? Where we be now? Yeah, we got so close, so close to love, but you had to go and mess it up. Was it all too much or just not enough? Where we got so close, so close to love. Yeah, we got so close, so close to love.
Senior faculty member that has inspired you during your time at Blair?
I would have to say Coach Saylor. Coach Saylor has changed my life a lot. He's a big part of the reason that I am where I'm at today.
Ashley Dye. Do not sleep on Ashley Dye.
Ashley Dye.
She's so cool. She's a beast.
I would say Mrs. Shaw. She's literally like my second mother here.
This man Tegna.
Probably Q, just because he's like, I love him, but like, hate him too. I definitely have to give like a big shout out to Mr. Patton, because I've just never had a teacher who was so genuinely like interested in what he taught.
Mamu, just because he's been my 3-year advisor and we like to hang out.
Easily Compton.
Still Moran. He's been a great guy and a great help to me. We always have great conversations, so I really appreciate him.
Probably, yeah, Mamu.
This is Letty. She's amazing.
Definitely Mamu.
Misty, because I've met like a lot of teachers who are just so happy all the time and always positive. It's not really genuine. But with her, she is genuinely just such a good person.
I'd like to thank Ms. Branwood. My junior year U.S. history class is just a ball. She's just a very welcoming, a very warm-hearted person, and I really appreciate all that she's done for me at Blair.
Mrs. Branwood, she's been my advisor for 3 years. I love her so much, and she's like my second mom.
I would like to thank Doc Sayers. He's an absolute stud. Back in my days of structured study hall, he was the guy to go to.
Definitely Mrs. Letty. Definitely Mr. Peruta.
I would say for faculty, Mrs. Ryerson. She's been my advisor all 4 years, and she's a gem. Oh, I'd say Miss Molman, because she's always just so positive and nice and welcoming, and she always has snacks in her room for us, which is like, she does not need to do that at all.
Mr. Trish, he is like the coolest, but at the same time, most humble person ever.
Miss D, love you. Like, miss your class a lot, and I appreciate you.
Mr. Wagner, Coach Wagner.
I just want to give a quick shout out to Mrs. Haddon. She definitely knows way too much about my life.
Mr. Garen. Mr. Garen's always been there.
Mr. Trish really inspired me. Miss Harry.
For me, Mr. Browse.
I would say Mr. Browse. He's my advisor, and he's been my coach since freshman year, so.
Really, Mr. Browse. He's my advisor, and he's just like the kindest person I've ever met in my life.
I wish somebody would have told me that someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage
this
to ask her. Wish I would have gotten out
yes
of that show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about
it.
I felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass, dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change.
maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got, till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got, till it goes, till it's gone.